your reservation. Hello, everybody, and welcome back to another episode of the Bbpn podcast show. Let me turn this music off so we can get started. Okay, now we're going to continue from the last podcast. The previous podcast, I was telling you about ideas, giving you ideas for business ideas for that you could start from home. Okay, so I want to continue. I gave you ideas for products that you can make at home and sell and make money. So now we're going to talk about juices, okay? Some juices that you can make. So we have carrot juice. Bobo tea is a good one that just came out. Infused teas and lemonades. Lemonade with ginger and strawberry. Eggnog, cojito, and sorrel. Now, I hope I pronounced that properly. Are just some ideas of things that you can make and sell. Let's talk about foods, okay? Seasonings, jams and jellies, pickles are a popular one. As you see in the stores, they're making, using a lot of pickles, pickle juice, sauces, barbecue, white sauce, meatballs, yum. Birria tacos is definitely a good one. I just tried that and I loved it. Empanadas, meat pies, or Jamaican beef patties, you can make beef patties, veggie patties, and chicken patties, okay? I've seen those, and they're absolutely delicious. Sliders, shepherd's pie, lasagna, vegetable lasagna. And what you do is you cut it up and you put it in a container, okay? And this is something that can be frozen. And the person can, they can freeze it in the freezer and eat it when they want, as long, like, just like chicken pot pie. Those are things that can be frozen, vegan foods, you can make diabetic foods, vegetarian foods, Chipotle is a good one, spicy foods, people like pizza and Chinese food. And I want to say, there's a lot of Americans out here, okay, who do make Chinese food and they can make pizza. My stepfather used to make, he had a wok and he used to have a cookbook and he would make Chinese food, and I mean, it was amazing. He did a very, very, very good job, okay? And just so you know, Chinese, if you look up the history of Chinese food, which a lot of people haven't, although Chinese places are not a franchise around here, they basically, the woman who came here to the US of A, Chinese or Asian woman, I don't even know what she was, but I know she was Asian. She Americanized Chinese food. So if you understand what I'm saying by that, it's actually pretty, not too difficult to make. And a lot of you are already out here making egg rolls and different type of rolls, okay? So you kind of have an idea that you can do this. Hibachi, soul food, barbecue. Soul food is what? It is a comfort food. This is, soul food is something that we eat all year round. We look forward to it, especially if you can cook it on a grill. Okay, we love food that's cooked on the grill. It tastes so good. Okay, soups. We have, winter is coming. People are getting sick. So if you could make homemade soup, popular. Chili, cornbread, macaroni and cheese. Now I want to talk about things like cornbread, and I want to be more specific about macaroni and cheese. And here's the deal. I went to the grocery store last year, okay, and especially around the holiday. There was a grocery store that I had never seen this. There was so much macaroni and cheese. They were selling it. They had it in a single serving size, half pan and a large pan, okay? And I remember this. I remember taking pictures of it, and I was looking at the prices because that's something that I do. I'm always looking at this, and I'm saying, wow, macaroni and cheese is a staple all year round in people's diets. People are making macaroni and cheese bites. They're making macaroni and cheese bowls. They're making it with seafood, mixing it with chicken. So if you're somebody who makes really good macaroni and cheese, and here's the thing, a lot of you guys come from families that have recipes that your grandparents have passed down to you, okay? Recipes for making, like I said, pain relief products, foods that are absolutely out of this world, things that actually help people. So, if you can make really, or you do make excellent macaroni and cheese, here's a tip for you. Now, we have, in your community, you have bodegas and you have like stores like carryout. Jody's Fish Market, and we have little small carryout places, okay? And they do really bang up business. Now here's the thing, they might get behind, and macaroni and cheese is something that they wouldn't mind buying from you, okay? So that could be your first contract, a mom and pop's place, a staple of the community, a place you can make something like macaroni and cheese or collard greens, or a lot of you make desserts, really good cakes and things that they can buy from you. So that could be your first contract. Now, you use that contract, make sure you, you know, take your time with the contract, okay? Make sure you can do it. So let's say you get the contract, they you serve, you put the macaroni and cheese in a container, you put your label on it, your company name, and you deliver three times a week, I say like 15 containers full of macaroni and cheese or something like banana pudding, okay? Just focus on that contract. Just make sure you can do it, okay? Fulfill that obligation with that. Make a contract with them for 3 months. Just say, listen, I can do this for 3 months, okay? If I do it for the 3 months, give me another 3 months, okay? That's how you will and deal with people, all right? And you even give them a discount, because here's the deal. You're going to use that contract to do what? Get another contract, okay? So if you get a rave review from that person, and you let everybody know, listen, that's my macaroni and cheese that's inside of Kay's barbecue place or the fish market, okay? So that's outstanding. That would be your first contract. And that's how you do that. You can get a contract with a senior citizen's home or even schools. Schools are looking for people. And we're going to talk about that later and how to go about doing that, because there's other things that you're going to need, of course, like insurance. And then we're going to talk about getting your DMV and your BBB and the other certifications that we're going to talk about. We're going to first finish giving you some ideas. Okay, so now I just want to give you a few more. Bean pies is another one. Did I say Chipotle? Okay, I did. Now, let's move on to, okay, we have that up. And I'm doing this for a reason, and I had to read it off because I can't remember all of the stuff, okay? So we have the foods. Now we're going to move to, and another one is breakfast I want to mention. If you're able to focus on specific times, because people are hungry, and it's really hard to get food out here. So if you're able to make breakfast even 3 or 5 times a week, oh my God, you're going to do very well, all right? So, and you can just focus on things like cornbread, just make that for someone and get a contract. Macaroni and cheese, like I said, any type of desserts, because a lot of people are not good with making desserts, okay? And it's timely, it takes a lot of time. So if you're good at that, do your thing, man. So the next thing you want to do is, if you in business, you can go into real estate, which is, if you want to be a landlord, so you want to rent out, you can rehab, remodel, and rent out a house, okay, or make it into a two-family home or single homes, okay, how would they do that? You can do an Airbnb, you can flip houses, you can buy writs or foreclosures, okay, you can do property management. Those are some ideas for you. Buy a parking lot, and you make money off of a parking lot, especially in an area, like say near a beach or a club, a nightclub where people want to park or a restaurant, okay, and charge them for that. So now, another idea for businesses in retail I want to talk about. Some retail business ideas are, no, you know what? I have so much of this information that I wrote down. I want to talk about services, okay, which I forgot to tell you. So services, some service ideas for your business are, here we go, AutoCAD, drone pilot, DJ, tattooing, virtual assistant, bookkeeping, taxes, copy editing, ghost writing, resume writing, a tutor, cybersecurity, blogger, photography, videography and editing, production, childcare, dog sitting, dog walking, house sitting, running errands, cleaning, moving, handyman, yard work, landscaping, pest control, painting, power washing, nails, makeup, hair, and hairstylist doing eyebrows, and esthetician, mole removal, setting up classes. Now, if you somebody who's been, I'm sorry, it's a little hot in here. It's like almost 90 degrees out here today. If you're somebody who has been in some type of business and you've been doing it for years and years and years and years, you can set up classes to teach people. I remember there was a Wilford Academy back in the day where I live, okay? They were teaching people, I think, cosmetology. So you can set up your own cosmetology course. You can set up, like, you can start with hair braiding classes, okay? You can set up with teaching people how to do eyebrows. And what else? You can teach people, modeling is a good one. Photography, computer, how to use a computer. Just how to use a computer or how to use a cell, how to use your cell phone. I remember Verizon, when I first, I don't know how long ago, if it was the iPhone 6 or iPhone 8. Verizon did have, before COVID, where they would teach you how to use, they had classes to teach you how to use the iPhone, okay? And they don't have that anymore. So these are things that people will need help with, like, how do I do this? How do I use social media is a good one too, okay? So those are classes. There's so much that you can teach. Real estate classes, okay? How to trade stocks is another one. Investing, you know, startup. What to do with your 401ks and your IRAs, okay? So financial information for people, financial advisor. Another one, I hate to say this is kind of morbid, but to teach people, let's say estate planning. So also upon someone's death, how to set up the funeral. A lot of us don't know what to do. And I mean, this is big business. I have no idea. I don't know what steps to take. We're going to get into that later, though, because I did put some information in my books about that, about estate planning. What to do, the burial, and your will, power of attorney, all of that information, financial literacy. You know, I put a lot of that information inside of my book, okay? So we're going to move on, and we're almost done, guys, okay? I'm going to, we talked about real estate. Mobile trucks is a good one, so I'm just going to give you a quick rundown. Medical transportation company is a very business. Tire repair, a 24-hour key for people who get locked out of their house a lot, food trucks, dessert trucks, hot dogs, like a breakfast truck, tacos, and bookmobile, ice cream, a production studio, and lastly, a party bus are just some of the ideas that I came up with for a mobile business, okay? Now, you can, for retail businesses, let me give you some ideas. A dispensary, a juice bar, distillery, liquor store, grooming for men only, hair salon, barbershop, floral or florist, funeral home, laundromat, beauty supply, grocery store, bodega. Okay? Bodega, a butcher, fish market. Carry out or a restaurant, a bakery are just some of the ideas. Detailing business and organic food market and vegan market, okay? These are just some ideas, especially for you who have money. And another way to raise money that I wanted to tell you is, why don't some of you come together? Some of you guys have money, okay? You can come together, put your money together, start an investment group or whatever, and raise the money yourself and start your first business, okay? If you guys have been buddies for a long time, a lot of you are very, very close since high school, since middle school, and you trust one another, why not put your money in and start a business, okay? Like I said, I mentioned earlier, a good one is having your own rolled cigars is very, very popular. I see a lot of people out here smoking cigars. I don't know what the phenomenon is for the women, but I do know the men do it, okay? So it's a big, you know, you can have your own. So now let's talk about, we're going to wind this down. Some other things that you can do to get in business. You can start, you can buy a already existing business, okay? You can buy into that. You can buy into a franchise. Or, lastly, and more importantly, you can start your own franchise, okay? A lot of you have had businesses for over 30 plus years, and you have a big following. The first thing that you want to do is to open up another business, another of the same business, clone yourself, okay? And that's the start of your franchise. Make sure that all your ingredients are written down, your prices, make everything uniform. What you did in one place, do in the next place, and keep going. And then you'll open up a third place, and now you can start your franchise, okay? You can get help with that. And a lot of your branding, and when you're starting to grow your business and you want to buy, or say you want to do, you want to start packaging your products to try to sell into the grocery stores or go into mass production, what you're going to do or who you can get help from, my suggestion, I live in New Jersey, so I could go to Rutgers, okay, Small Business Development Center, and that's what they do there. They help you to move up, okay, into the next level. They're very good with that. So in your area, in each state, they have small business development centers, and most of them are basically located near universities or inside of universities. So just look up in your state or your territory where your small business development center. Look up SBDCs, okay? And I've gotten a lot of help from the SBDCs for my business planning, my writing my business plans, and like I've told you, a lot of my paperwork I learned how to do from the Small Business Development Center and from the SCORE mentors, okay? And I've always used the SBA.gov site for a lot of, to get me a lot of help with my business, okay? With my business knowledge, my business know-how, okay? So you have a lot of information. So our next, and I forgot one more thing importantly, sitting right in front of my face, and that's why I put it here. This is a good one. Now, you can, if you're an entertainer, you're someone who's into sports, or you're an athlete, you have a lot of money, you're an influencer, or you're just somebody who's very popular around your community, okay? You can brand your own pre-made products. And you're saying, what are you talking about, Melissa? Okay, let's say that you are you do cosmetics, okay? You're into makeup, okay? You're into makeup artistry, okay? I'm not really sure if that's the correct term for it. But anyway, you can order makeup palettes and rebranding, okay? Where do you order this stuff from? Places like Alibaba.com, Alibaba Express, and rebrand it with your company name on it, okay? Your trademark. So some things that you can order and rebrand are lipstick, lip gloss, okay? You can have your own popping lip gloss out here, okay? You can have, like I said, makeup, eyelashes, press-on nails is another one. There's so many things that you can do. You can also brand your, I said eyelashes, and you can brand, this is a good one. So a lot of you are into fitness. If you are a trainer or you have your own gym, you can brand a protein powder, okay, and vitamins, water, and the list goes on. There's so many things that you can put your company name on, okay, and sell it. Ladies, those of you who have hair salons, you can buy products already pre-made and pre-mixed for you, such as hair products. The hair growth oils, you can rebrand. Now, the hair growth oil that I have, I made and mixed myself, okay? You can do that as well. But you can brand other products like lotions and anything to do with your business. And all this is an upsell for you, okay? This is how you do business. You can brand products in your hair salon, your store, with your company name on it, okay? I know many restaurants that have, they sell soda, like say Pepsi or Coca-Cola, and right next to it, they have their own company name on it. And for those of you who have seen this in grocery stores, on the grocery shelves, you'll see Rice Krispies or Corn Flakes made by one company, and then you'll see one made by the store itself, okay? So you can rebrand your own products. Some companies, I have them listed in my books, are called Anoxia and Envy Lab, okay? So you can order my books at Amazon.com, Start Your Own Damn Business, and I have several others listed there, and all that information is on there, okay? So we're going to close this out, and I hope that I gave you a lot of good information. The next podcast, we're going to talk about insuring your business and why that's necessary, and I'm going to give you low-cost insurance and even insurance that you can use for that day, okay? Just for, like, say you have an event for the day and you need to have insurance, I'm going to make sure that I give you that information. It's pretty feasible. It's cheap for you, okay? It's inexpensive. It's affordable, okay? And a lot of things I'm doing is because we are in inflation. We are still in COVID, and we have some other things that we're dealing with, like, you know, monkeypox and other things. So we're going into winter, and I know that a lot of these things are costly, but I'm trying to give you free information or low cost that will fit into a budget. And I'm trying to give you information that will help you get capital for your business, okay? All you have to do is follow the steps that I've given you. Play back this YouTube as many times as you need to. And thank you, guys. We're also going to talk about in the podcast, we're going to talk about insuring your business, why you need to do that, and we're going to move into marketing, and we're going to get you your first, we're going to help you get customers and your first contracts, okay? And the reason why I'm moving like this, we'll do the rest of the other things, like the DMV and the BBB, and get certifications later. But we want to do these steps right now because it is time for you to start making some money in the business. Let's see what you can do, okay? Thank you for joining me. This is the Bbpn Business Podcast. I'm Melissa C. Williams, and I will see you again. Peace and blessings, everybody.